Hey guys, Smoke to Do here, of course, and today we're discussing the Zara. In particular, a Zara Riot game that I've had, and I think it's pretty fun to show, actually. It was just a pretty interesting game. I thought it was worth showing as well. Plus, pretty interesting result. As you can see, Indivision with Sallisto in his Sinop. Sinop, great choice for ranked. Obviously, ranked season is over, but there will be follow-up seasons, so if you're interested in competing for ranked in a later date when it comes into fruition, this is certainly something you can look at for a later date. Now, the Zara is actually a very good kiting cruiser because of a couple things. It's got its get out of jail free exhaust smoke. Basically, if you're taking too much fire, you can always use that smoke screen and you can use that to disengage and go dark. It's pretty darn stealthy, so you can disengage when you want. It's pretty fast as well, and it's got a pretty darn good armor scheme. It's actually got a 30mm armor belt. Plus, the AP on it is actually remarkably great. As you see, AP on it broadside Nakato, you definitely want to use it when you can. 4 of a bend, yeah, sure, but 5 total hits that are penetrating and only a couple shatters. Pretty good. Again, AP in the King George, probably lackluster. No, well, more pens than no damaging hits, though. Again, we're up to 7k here, and we're still, you know, this is the cruiser reload. This is pretty quick reload. Angled Leon, again, it depends where you hit. Obviously, the Zara has a long reload, because the Italian cruisers generally have a longer reload, but the big caliber gun really does help out. Now, what we're doing here is we're going off to the side here, and we're just buying our time waiting for the right opportunity. Italians are great at just catching people off guard and just getting some really nice salvos. Unfortunately, well, decent-ish salvo, but we didn't get the citadels we wanted. So we've already got ourselves up to 10k damage here. York has given us the juiciest broadside we can see, so hopefully we can capitalize. Oh, we certainly have. Almost a dev strike, but not the full cookie, shall I say. Right now, we're the only ship over here, so anyone that tries to shoot us is turning their guns away from the entire friendly team, and that is what you mean being called in a crossfire, being caught in a crossfire. And that really is what sells the kiting cruiser playstyle if you're doing that right. It's like the Cabros / kiting ideal playstyle. We had the AP salvo on the York, and we do finish him off, and we double strike the DD. You may have noticed, guys, throughout the game, we're just launching torps whenever we can in areas of high traffic, and you can see the results. It's not always going to death strike a DD, but hey, one torp may cause one flood that will kill a ship. Flooding is still very, 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 very strong in this game. Honestly, they need to make it fire duration 30 seconds. I don't see why it takes so unbelievably long. They had the problem in PC and they fixed it, but maybe we'll have to see here, because carriers causing flooding torps is pretty darn meh. Still got AP on. HE could be a good switch here. Kind of should have an angled Leon, so we do switch after we fire what we have in the chamber. And we're still kind of kiting away here. We can bounce Leon here, but it's kind of a... it's a very hard, it's not a guaranteed thing. You have to be very careful if you're angling, and even if you are careful, sometimes you can just get unlucky because your bow is not 30mm, only your armoured belt, so you can't always bounce everything if they manage to hit your nose. So, Leon does get set on fire. He instantly damages controls, so we're going to set another HE salvo his way. We're just going to be very careful here. We do not want to run into the map board here. We're trying to duke the shots here. We're coming in, and we think we avoid those, and anything we did hit, we think we bounced them, so that's, we're doing that bad. We're going to kick out the speed here and try and get all four guns into the mix here. Do miss Leon, actually. Again, torps still sending them out. Yeah, I know there's no more DDs left, but it certainly is worth firing them anyway. Now, Leon's fired, so we don't mind giving a little bit of broadside. Of course, French battleship shells are quite quick, so we gotta give that some respect. So we are taking the time while Leon's reloading to get the open up our angle and get some more shots in. Now, Leon's got a surprisingly good deck. It's like 50mm on certain parts, but even a shattering HE shell can set a fire. So we're gonna just basically going to do that. Yeah, getting some pens, getting some armor pushing in here. We got some cover on the island there. Probably not much, completely shot over, but it does help that we can really brutalize that poor Leon. So Leon's down here. We've actually picked up kill number 3 here. Leon did get battered by our teammates, and that is 100% true, but yeah, we did what we could to distract him and prevent our team from taking too much damage indeed. Still get HE on, perfectly fine. We can use HE on the Nagato and get some HE on the King George. Nagato's quite far away, so AP will be less effective, and King George is heavily angled, so we're going to continue with our HE. If you can spread the fires about, that gives us some more damage control cooldowns, and some more problems for them in general. Our torpedoes are off cooldown. King George takes a massive hit from our team there, probably Celesto, we don't know. And we are basically going to rush this King George because, yeah, we've got all this health and it's only 2 ships left. Fire the Nagato, we may probably potentially torp the, the King George. We pop our rolling smoke a little bit early, but it's fine. He may not notice us, and that is really the point of it. So there's a very angry smoke screen coming towards his way. Just checking my smoke firing penalty, so it basically means we're not going to shoot. We're going to hold our fire and use our torpedoes at the right time. Celesto just blaps the King George again with his sin up, and he picks up high caliber. At this point, there's no point being stealthy. We're just trying to get in there. And can we bag slash secure the kill on the King George? Oh no, unfortunately the ICA does take that kill. Unfortunate. But hey, we've still got a potential Nagato to bag. So, after we enter the chamber here, we're going to switch to AP. Nagato at this range, we can comfortably citadel as well. As you see, the HE does some phenomenal damage here, and we're just gonna kind of ambush him behind the island. Now, Nagato guns turn pretty awfully, the armor is pretty awful, the guns are pretty inaccurate, very close ranges, the torpedo protection is okay, I guess. That's probably the only thing good about the Nagato as it stands, unfortunately. But yeah, one day maybe they'll give it a more significant buff, maybe something like New Mexico got, you know. But you never know, as much as me, just I can only hope. So, angled Nagato, probably still should AP at it. As you can see, he's still pretty effective, just even a little bit high in the superstructure. Got a torpedo sent, and let's just see, probably we're going to tank his initial salvo, because it's Nagato. Yep. is that the salvo? And you see, we just absolutely brutalize him. Full broadside to our battleship at point blank range, and he still can't kill us, and that is exactly why the Nagato suffers. So yeah, we actually pick up 4 out of the 5 kills for a ranked game. Yeah, pretty fun game for me. Pretty stoked it was, and yeah. 70k, devastating strike, double strike. First Bloods, 4 kills. And Celesto did pick up a handsome high caliber as well. If only the King George did not die to the Akka, we could have got all 5 kills in a ranked game. Yeah, pretty interesting. The question is though, like, who won the game there? Was it Celesto and the team killing, like getting the majority of the health for the ships? Or was it just the carry on the other side, you know? It's interesting to think about, and you know, hope this guys helps you out for future potential tricks for ranked. And yeah, hope it's a fun game for you guys to enjoy. I'll catch you on the flip side. Bye for now.